Hello, welcome to this tutorial dedicated to Autodesk AutoCAD, one of the best CAD softwares for Windows and Mac OS, to realize 2D and 3D designs. It is available through monthly or yearly subscriptions, or with limited tokens if you do not use it often. In just 12 minutes, we are going to cover all 2D and 3D basics you need to start using it. When you first open AutoCAD, the Start page appears with online tips, recent projects, and news from Autodesk. On the left side of the page, you can either go to Open to browse for an existing project, or New to start with a blank project, by taking a ready template. In this tutorial, we will be using the default acad.dwt template. The new project opens on the main interface. You always come back to the previous Start page by clicking on the Start tab. The main interface is composed of a big preview, the ribbon with several tools you can use, the visualization tools on the right, and the command line at the bottom we are going to see. You can use the Minimize button on top to change the ribbon size, and also hide or show any tool from the View tab. Now let's move on to 2D drawing. Any new project is ready for 2D design and comes with a gizmo system located in the bottom left corner, also known as User Coordinate System, UCS. The X-axis is represented by a red line for horizontal direction, while the Y-axis by a green line for vertical direction. Together, the X and Y axes define the ground plane, or work plane, where 2D designs lay. Open the Home tab and go to the Draw section to access all the tools to draw several 2D shapes. You can click on the down arrow to change the way to drop the same object, hovering over any button to get hints and tips. In this video, we will only cover the default drawings. Enable the Line or the Polyline tool and click twice on the preview to draw a straight segment. You will go on dropping others until you press the Escape key to stop. You can enable the tool again with the Enter key. Enable the Circle tool to drop a circle with 2 points. To draw an arc, enable the Arc tool and drop 3 points instead. Press the Enter key to enable the tool again and drop another arc. Use the Rectangle or the Polygon tool to draw these shapes. Type the number of sides, apply with the Enter key, and fix 2 points to drop the shape. Enable the Ellipse tool to drop an ellipse with 3 points. AutoCAD offers several measurements and drawing aids to make your drawing effective and efficient. While drawing, AutoCAD provides a live preview of the object in progress along with its measurements. To undo the drawing, simply press the Escape key. When drawing a line, AutoCAD shows the angle degrees with respect to the X-axis and the length measurement in accordance with the unit set for the project. To change this unit, type units and press Enter. On the new dialog box, you can set the unit to use, its format, and precision. Precise values can also be typed directly, using the Tab key to apply it and move on to the next step. Press the Enter key to proceed to the next drawing step. Drawing aids are all collected in the bottom right corner. The Grid Mode button can be used to turn the drawing grid on and off. The Snap Mode to turn on or off snapping to the grid while drawing. With Ortho Mode, you can draw through the X or Y axis only. You can enable Object Snap to snap object key points, which can be selected from the list next to the Snap button. The key points include object endpoints, centers, midpoints, intersections, and perpendicular directions, shown in green color. You can also use these to extract dash green guidelines connecting other key points. You can use the keyboard to ease the drawing process. For example, type polyline and press Enter to enable the polyline tool. The command line will show several options with blue letters highlighted at the bottom. Type A and press Enter to enable arc and drop a curve. Type L and press Enter to enable line and drop segments again. and type C to close the polyline shape. You can also use the up and down arrow keys to select the same options and apply with the Enter key. When you don't have any drawing tool enabled, your cursor is in selection mode, indicated by a small square within it. You can click on any object to select it, highlight it in blue color, and start editing it. Use Control or Command and XCV keys to cut, copy, and paste a selected object. To remove it, you can press the Delete key. To undo your last action, use Control or Command and Z. When you select any object, several blue nodes appear on it depending on its shape. On lines, arcs, circles, and ellipses, you can drag the central node to move the object or drag other nodes to resize it. You can also hover over the nodes to get additional information and options. You can use Stretch to move endpoints, Lengthen to adjust the line or arc length, or Radius to change the arc radius. When selecting polylines, rectangles, and polygons, you get bigger and smaller nodes. Drag from the bigger nodes to move, add or remove selected vertices. Use the smaller nodes to manage the sides. Select Stretch to move the side. Add Vertex to add a new vertex at the side midpoint, or Convert to Arc or Line to turn the side into a curve or segment. You can also edit multiple objects by selecting all of these together. Click on each object to be selected, or click and drag to select large groups of objects with the lasso. Dragging from left to right will activate the window lasso, which selects objects fully included within the blue area. Dragging from right to left will enable the crossing lasso, which selects objects touching the green area. To deselect any object, hold down the Shift key and click on it. To deselect all objects, use the Escape key instead. Open the Home tab and go to Modify to get all the tools to edit 2D drawings. To move an object or a group of them, select these first and enable the Move tool. You can also enable the Rotate tool to rotate the selection, setting rotation point and angle as needed. With the Scale tool, you scale a selected object without deforming it. To adjust the preview over your project, you can zoom in and out around the cursor with your mouse wheel. From the right side, you can also enable the Pan tool to click and drag to pan. To end any tool, simply press the Escape key. The 3D view cube displays the point of view seen on the project. Use the arrows above the cube to rotate the view by 90 degrees and drag its circumference to rotate in 2D. Let's see how to build 3D objects in AutoCAD. First of all, you have to switch to a 3D preview. To do so, click on any vertex or side of the 3D view cube, or enable the Orbit command to 3D rotate your project. On a 3D preview, the UCS shows a third Z blue axis, representing the height from the work plane. If you are more familiar with an XZ convention on the work plane, you can change the UCS by selecting it, right-clicking on it, and going to Z axis, placing the Y axis on top. The 3D drawing tools may be hidden by default. In this case, right-click on the top bar and go to Show Tabs 3D Tools. This opens the 3D tools under the Modeling section. You can hover over any tool to get tips and hints on how to draw each 3D solid. The Box tool allows you to create a 3D box by defining a base on the XY plane, followed by its extrusion on the Z axis. The Sphere tool, on the other hand, allows you to create a sphere by dropping 2 points. These 3D solids are shown with their skeleton called wireframe according to the default wireframe view selected from the top left corner. You can show the 3D volume with either realistic or X-ray. You can create more complex 3D solids from 2D drawings. For example, the Extrude tool adds extrusion to a 2D drawing laying on the ground plane. Just select the 2D object, apply with Enter, and set the extrusion to build the 3D object. The Revolve tool allows you to make a 3D solid by rotating a 2D section. In this case, select the section, apply with Enter, fix two points to set the rotating axis, and fix another point to create the object. You can edit these 3D objects with their blue nodes as seen for 2D. Select any object to show a gizmo system on it that you can use to move, scale, and rotate across each axis. You can change the gizmo type from selection above. You can build meshes to make more complex 3D objects. These are made of smaller polygons that, edited singularly, allow you to make very custom shapes. Extend the modeling section to enable any mesh tool and drop one. You can also transform any 3D solid into a mesh by selecting it and going to Convert to Mesh. You can edit an entire mesh with the gizmo system, or hold down the Control or Command key to select portions from such mesh. This way, if you move these polygons, you customize the shape of the mesh as you like. To improve accuracy, increase the smooth level and use Mesh Refine from above, increasing the number of polygons composing the mesh. Finally, to convert the mesh to a 3D solid, type Convert to Solid on the command line, press Enter, select the mesh, and press Enter again. To save your project, click on the AutoCAD icon and go to Save As. Your project will be saved as a .dwg file, which you can open anytime you need. To export the project, click on the Output tab and select Export. You can choose a .dwft or a .dwf file to share your work as read-only, or a .pdf document to send the work to a printer. Whereas, to get a realistic render of your 3D project, go to the Visualize tab, and then to Render to Size. Check it out! Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Make sure to check out our YouTube channel and our website to learn more about other CAD software and other outstanding tools.